Hey guys, welcome to Excel trick number 2. Friends, this trick is so awesome that trust me, you will love this trick. The work on which you have to spend hours of your time, you will be able to finish that work within seconds by using this trick. So what this trick is all about? Actually, this trick belongs to magical use of hyperlink. As we know, simply the hyperlink is used to link different files in our Excel sheet that helps us to get instant access to multiple files from one location. For example, here I have been linked these three documents, photo, ID card and contract of this employee 11001 using hyperlink. So when I will click on this cell, this will open photo of this employee 11001. When I will click on this cell, this will open ID card of this employee and so on. So this is actually simple use of hyperlink. So where is magical use of hyperlink, or how we can use magically the hyperlink? To understand or to learn magical use of hyperlink, let's take here example of a person who is working as a document controller in a company and he knows how to use hyperlink. So he has created or he has linked these three documents in this worksheet. So now that person wants to link same three documents for all employees in this worksheet. For that he has created here this table. He has written here same three documents for each employee number. But here the thing is, the total number of employees of this company are 540. That means if he want to link three documents for each employee, the total number of documents that he need to link here will be more than 1600. Now the problem for that person is that if he is going to link these more than 1600 documents here, this will take too much time. So what he should do? Actually, here we have solution to this problem. Just let me show you. Here you can see we have four lines, and in these four lines we have linked all these documents here, and this will not take more than 1 minute. So how we can do this? The most important question is how we can link all these documents in less than 1 minute. So for that, just I will copy this and I will paste it here, because we are going to do this from very beginning level. Then what we need to do for employee numbers, we will just create here drop down list. Just let me show you first. Here you can see we have here employee numbers. Suppose we want to see photo of employee number, maybe 11010. What we will do, we will go to this drop down list, we will select this employee number, and then we will click here, and you will see this is opening employee number 11010, photo of this employee. Now suppose we want to open maybe contract of employee number 11001, maybe one. What we will do, we will just select this employee number, we will click here, this will open contract of this employee number 11001. So how we can do this? We are going to discuss this. So here what we will do, we will create here drop down list. Here you can see we have here all employee numbers that we need to link here. So what we will do, we will go to data, then data validation, then data in data validation we will select list. In list we will just click here, and then we will go to this list, sorry, this sheet. We will select all these employee numbers and then we will go for OK. And now you can see we have created here drop down list. Just let me highlight this. So now what to do? First of all, that thing we did here, we have created here drop down list. So what we need to do, suppose now we want to link here contracts first. But one thing that you need to see, because you want to link all these three documents, you need to create three folders with same name. I have here, I will show you. Here you can see I have here these three folders. Now suppose we want to link these contracts here. So what we will do, we will go to same folder to contracts, and here we will just copy from here this complete address of this folder. Then we will go back to this Excel sheet, and here simply we will paste this address. After that, we will just in next cell, we will use equal sign. We will select this cell, then and sign, inverted commas, backslash, inverted commas, then again and sign, and then we will select this cell in which we have been created our drop down list. Again and sign, inverted commas. Now next thing here, as we know, as we have here, all copies of contracts are in PDF format. We will simply use here .pdf, inverted commas, and here we go. Now you can see we have been created here our formula. What we will do, we will use here hyperlink equal hyperlink, and then here we will select here our location this cell, comma, then friendly name, maybe we will use here. Click here to open, bracket close and enter. And when I will click on this cell, it should open contract of this employee 11003. So here we go. When I will change it, maybe I will go to 11006. I will click here and this will open contract of 11006. So this is very easy, and I think this will not take more than 1 minute even. So now I will do same thing for ID card and photo. Now here you need to see, these are photos. So these photos are in JPG format. So what we will do, we will just write here JPG format in place of PDF format. So now we will use hyperlink here, same as we did before. So simply we will just copy here from here. We will paste here, and this we will just change reference cell to L8. So now this is ready. So now let's try this. For employee number 11006, let's try to open ID card. I will click on this and it should open. See, 11006 and photo 11006, and let's change it and maybe 11 10. Okay, ID card, and it will open ID card. Photo, it is also working. So friends, now everything here is working properly. These two columns you can simply hide from here. Now this was easy, because here the drop down list that we created here, for this drop down list we had here list of all these employee numbers that we need to use to create this drop down list. But sometimes what we have, sometimes we simply have scanned copies of all the files that we want to link in our Excel sheet, but we don't have list of names of all these files. So if we don't have list of names of all those files, how we can create this drop down list if we don't have same like this list of all the names of files that we want to link in our Excel sheet. So now the question is, if we don't have list of names of all such files, how we can export a list of names of all such files? Here you can see, because here you can see these are documents for all different vehicles, and you can see here these vehicle numbers are all different. These are not same, or these are not in serial. So now how I can export these names? So first of all, what we need to do, we need to go to in the folder in which we have all these files. You can see here now I'm in this folder. I will just copy from here address of this folder, then I will go from to here I will go to right here cmd, and this will show me command prompt. So I will go to this, and here I will simply write here cd space, and then I will paste here address of folder that I copied from there. Then I will press enter, and here you can see now we are in that folder. Then I will write here dir space slash b, then space slash, then o n space, then I will insert this sign, and then I will write here the name of file that I want to export. So what I will do, suppose I want to export list of names of all these files in Excel file, and maybe I want the name of that file maybe as vehicle.xls. xls mean Excel format. I will press enter, and now it should have been created here one new file, and here you can see this is that file. So when I will open this file, so now you can see this file has list of names of all those vehicles or all those documents that I have in this file, in this folder. So this is, you can see here, this is name of that Excel file. So I will, that I created just right now. So I will just remove it from here. Now what we need to do, we just need to remove from here this extension that is JPG. How we will remove this extension from these names of all those files? We will use here left function. Then we will select this cell, comma, len, minus. You can see here how many characters we want to remove from right side, 1 2 3 4. we want to remove four characters including this dot. So minus here 4, bracket close, and here we go. You can see here this is name of that file. So we will just drag it down, copy, and we will just paste a simple text. And now this is list of all those files. So now we can use this list to create this drop-down list that we need to create to link all these files in our Excel sheet. So friends, that's all. If you like this video, don't forget to give thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe our channel and press bell icon button so that you don't miss any new coming video on our channel. And also don't forget to share this knowledge with your friends. At last, thanks for watching. Bye bye.